sits alone at a table in a small cafe, drowning his tears in a bottomless cup of coffee. And he's tumbling into his thoughts. His memories are all tied in knots. Who is going to save him? No one wants to know him. She stands alone in a place where no one knows her name. She catches them staring, they turn around and finish the frame. And she's nursing her head and her pride. She died long ago, deep down inside. Who is going to save her? No one wants to know her. I can't believe that you pull on the sleeve when you cry.
When you cry,
you're sick in the night. Stop living the lie. Oh. Stop living the lie. He sits alone and looks up to the eyes of an angel. Catches him staring and smiles the smile of an angel. And she asks him if this chair is free. He says, yes, will you sit here with me? No one would have saved them. We should all learn.
Yeah. Remember Diverse FM. These are the good old days. These are the good old days. Well, he's back. New station, new name. You're not dreaming. He's really back. DJ Ty on Cyrus FM.
You're listening to Ben Watts on Storm FM. Playing you the greatest club music of all time. Don't forget to get involved with the show using the chat room or contact him through the website www.stormfm.net or email studio@stormfm.net.
The Supreme Court has decided British prisoners do not have the right to vote under European law. Two inmates, one from England, the other from Scotland, had argued that EU rules should override British law. But Mark Leach, who runs ex-offenders charity Converse, says it makes little sense for those convicted of minor crimes.
People like Ian Huntley, paedophiles, arsonists, robbers, murderers, all those kind of people at one end of the scale are not allowed to vote. But so too is the person serving 7 days for shoplifting who just happens to be in custody at a time when there's a general election.
The Prime Minister says the actions of three officers from the Police Federation during the Plebgate row was not acceptable. They're accused of lying about what was said during a meeting with the MP Andrew Mitchell. Yesterday, the police watchdog said the officers should have faced a misconduct hearing. The Prime Minister agrees and thinks they should say sorry to Andrew Mitchell too.
The Right Honourable Gentleman is absolutely right. He has owed an apology. The conduct of these officers was not acceptable. These things should be properly investigated, as the Home Secretary has said.
The number of people in work has reached an all-time record high of almost 30 million. Official figures also show that between June and August, unemployment fell by 18,000 to 2.49 million. A senior registrar says as many as one in five marriages in urban parts of the country could be bogus. There were 1,800 suspicious ceremonies reported in England and Wales last year, but the real figure could be closer to 15,000. Police say they've smashed an international drug smuggling ring involving cargo handlers at Heathrow Airport. 11 people were arrested and pure cocaine worth millions of pounds found in dawn raids.